Welcome back. You're watching Profit Fundamentals. Let's just dip back into the markets briefly, see how things are shaping up. You're still down about 0.7% to 0.8% technical weakness, global weakness, and of course nervousness around the economy, political economy, all sort of coming together, taking the Nifty down to 56.25 and breaking the 200 DMA in morning trade. The currency markets also not looking particularly great, and the rupees down at four-week lows. So, you know, keep an eye out on that as well. And I haven't touched base with the bond markets. Let's just do a quick check on what the 10-year yield is looking like. That's been hovering around 8% as well, and right now actually softer at 7.94. Actually, on the fiscal side, there have been positive comments that have been coming in from both the Prime Minister, who reiterated his commitment to fiscal consolidation, but also last year's fiscal numbers were better, and some comments coming out from the Economic Affairs Secretary has been saying that they may actually better the fiscal targets that have been set for this year. So on the fiscal side, there is some improvement. There is also, of course, a bond auction tomorrow, the first of the fiscal. Let's get into what the corporate sector has in store in the next fiscal. Ratings have been an issue over the last few years as the economic environment has deteriorated. Is the situation improving? We spoke to Pawan Agarwal, Senior Director at Crisil Rating, and started by asking him what he thinks Corporate India's credit standing and credit rating outlook for FY14 would be.
That we publish, which is essentially an amalgamation and aggregation of the rating actions that we take during the year. And based on those rating actions, how is it that we see the credit quality panning out? If you look at, we today have ratings on about 12,000 companies, and which represent about 45% of the banking sector credit outstanding. So clearly it is a far more representative of what is happening in the corporate India. If you look at and step back a little, in October of 2012, we had said that we believe that the credit quality pressures are now bottoming out. And that is what, if you look at what the last 6 months have shown, the data and the rating actions that we have done, that is turning out to be true. So what are the trends in the last 6 months showing us? The pressure on credit quality, although it continues, but the pace of decline has come down. We measure this by a ratio called a credit ratio. And the credit ratio stood at 0.62 times, a relative indicator of upgrades and downgrades. At 0.62 times for the second half of 2012-13, it is deteriorated a little, but largely stable at 0.66 times in the first half, compared to 0.9 times that was there in the second half of previous financial year. So clearly you are seeing that the pressure is stabilizing. The second element that we have, that is indicator which confirms this, is the fact that default rates have largely remained stable during the second half as compared to the first half, at about 4.2%, and also the downgrade rate, which is the number of companies downgraded to the number of companies that we rate, that also has remained stable at about 12%. Now, all of that indicates that going forward, the stability of the credit that we have seen, combined with the fact that the expectation on economic growth outlook to be better, we expect that the economic growth will be 6.3% next year. Coupled with the fact that profitability is likely to be relatively better because two elements, one is the interest rates are expected to be lower for the industry, and second is the commodity prices are cooling off. So both these indicators put together make us believe that the credit quality pressures that we have been seeing will ease, and the credit ratio therefore will start or begin its journey back to improvement. Although that improvement we do not believe is going to be very, very material, it is still going to be indicative of the pressure which is there, and overall downgrades will continue to outnumber upgrades.
Sir, you know, working capital, and before I go across to that question, I just want to flag off that Rahul Gandhi has just arrived at that CII annual summit. He should be speaking anytime. There's a lot of interest in that speech. First time he's addressing an economic business gathering. We want to know what he has to say. But before, we get across to that, let me try and slip in one other question to Mr. Agarwal. Just want to understand, what do you think is going to translate into material improvement in terms of working capital and balance sheet improvement?
The working capital situation actually is actually weakening. We have seen that throughout 2012-13, the working capital position overall of the industry has actually weakened. The number of days working capital has actually increased, and that is an element which we believe will remain a very important monitorable for us. We do not believe that there are signs of improvement in working capital in the near term, but if situation improves going forward, that is something which will reduce the stress which is there. On the balance sheet size side, the other element which can reduce the stress is equity infusion, because some of the companies that have large debt and where the outlook is also a little weaker, those are the companies where you will expect some equity to come in to reduce the pressure on the balance sheets.
All right. Mr. Agarwal, let me ask you one other question on sectoral trends as we still wait for Mr. Rahul Gandhi to take the stage. What are you seeing in terms of sectoral trends?
Yeah. So if you look at the sectors where or the companies where we believe the credit quality will improve, essentially the companies which have managed the downturn very well, the companies that have prudently managed their capital expenditure, the companies that operate in less capital intensive sectors, those are the companies which we believe where the credit quality will improve. I think it will also come from, these companies largely will come from sectors like pharmaceuticals, packaged foods, which is where we have also seen the highest number of upgrade rate in the past 6 months. We believe that is something that will continue. On the other side, if you look at on the credit quality weakness, the sectors which will remain under pressure and therefore the companies will continue to see some deterioration in credit quality will be the construction, the power, the engineering, the capital goods, the textiles. Essentially, the sectors where debt levels are high and sectors where material improvement in investment climate needs to happen for the credit quality pressure to come down a little.
All right, I think we'll leave it at that for now. Thanks so much, Mr. Agarwal, for joining us. Lots of interest there. Adi Godrej is introducing Rahul Gandhi, so I think we should just cut across. Yeah,